London Dreams is the stuff nightmares are made of. Here's why. You don't want to see 40 plus actors behaving like 20 year olds in a school music band. You also don't want to see Salman Khan play the Punjabi munda who is so innocent that he is misled into taking drugs. In addition, you'll tire of seeing Aasin being praised for her talent in the film, while you get to see none of it. This drama from Vipul Shah has too many loopholes, from the plot to the acting and the most non-rock music ever. Watch London Dreams only if you want to stay awake at the horror of it later. 5 out of 5 for this one. Those dreams are shattered, but if you're thinking some of Aladdin's came true, well, not quite. Aladdin and his genie make full efforts to whip some comic scenes and wizardry together. They partially succeed in the first half of the film. But after the interval, director Sujoy Ghosh gets too carried away with special effects. Ritesh Deshmukh as the lost Aladdin, Amitabh Bachchan as the flamboyant genie, and Sanjay Dutt as the wicked ringmaster are at the top of their games. And yet the squeezing in of one too many magical moments takes the magic away from the movie. As far as Jacqueline Fernandez goes, one should have wished for a better role for herself. Aladdin gets 2 stars only for the performances of the 3 key male performers. Make a wish. Moving on to a different land altogether, we were expecting Antarctica to be an exciting enough base for at least a tolerable film. But White Out disappoints. Kate Beckinsale as the US Marshal posted in the unforgiving cold country to investigate a murder case is not bad, and tries her best to make this suspense thriller a success. What starts as a promising storyline soon fizzles out, all thanks to a weak and predictable storyline. We give the film 1.5 stars.